In this video, we'll take a look at creating compound data types in Rust. We'll create a new cargo project, open it in VS Code, and remove the Hello World statement cargo added for us. We'll start by creating a simple array of U32s. Notice that Rust has inferred the type of the array, and Rust Analyzer has added a helpful annotation for us. If Rust can't infer the type for some reason, we can always add it explicitly ourselves. Notice that the length of the array is part of its type. If we add another element, we'll get an error, which Rust Analyzer displays for us in our editor. We can access the first element of this array using index notation. If we try to access the array at an index where it's clear to the compiler the index is outside of the array, we'll get a warning saying exactly that. If we instead access the array with an index that the compiler doesn't know is outside of the array, the code compiles without warnings. When we run this code, though, we'll get a panic, which crashes our program. Let's see what happens when we try to put something of the wrong type in our array. We get a compiler error showing that arrays always have to have elements of the same type. If we want to set to create a continuous collection of items of differing types, we can use tuples. Rust always tries to infer the types here, but in this case, it's unsure what type of number the second item in our tuple is. Let's add the type of the tuple explicitly. We can do this by adding parentheses and listing the type of each item in the tuple. Accessing elements in the tuple is done with dot notation. This always means accessing an index that doesn't exist in a tuple is a compiler error. That's the basics of using compound data types in Rust.